Hi guys, I'm Usman, a prep class tutor. Welcome to today's section of Learning Mathematics with Prep Class. In this video, we are going to continue our solving from the Yugo-Siugo Mathematics past question. In our previous video, we solved questions 1 to 5 from the Yugo-Siugo Mathematics past question. Now in this video, we are going to solve question number 6 to 10. The essence of this video is to build and guide you through solving questions in mathematics examinations. So stay with us and learn with us, because Prep Class is ready to build your learning skills. Kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel to get access to all our videos in a very orderly fashion. Now, let's begin solving questions. Question number 6 to 10 will be solved in this video. Now we start. Question number 6. Find the cube root of 2744. We have the options: A, 14, B, 9, C, 18, D, 12, and E, 15. How can you solve this question? What should come to your mind when solving this question? That is how you should ask yourself when you come across a mathematics question. Now from the question, find the cube root of 2744. The question is, what is cube root? Cube root means a number we are to multiply by itself 3 times to get the given number. So it means to find the cube root of 2744, we need to find a number that when we multiply it by itself 3 times, we are going to get 2744. Now looking at this number might seem big to you. But by the time you further break down this number into a smaller form, then it will be easy for you to get the number such that when you multiply it to itself 3 times, you are going to get 2744. Now to do this, we use the LCM method, or we say the division method, to break down this number. Now we start by dividing by 2. 2 can easily divide this number. So how many 2 are we going to see in 2744? So we say 2 in 2, that is 1. 2 in 7, that is 3. There's a remainder of 1. So we add that 1 to this 4, making 14. How many 2 can we see in 14? That is 7. 2 in 4, that's giving us 2. So this means that 2 in 2744 is giving us 1372. Now we continue again. Since we can still divide with 2, how many 2 can we see in 1372? We start by saying, how many 2 can we see in 13? That is 6, remainder 1. This one will join 7 to give us 17. How many 2 can we see in 17? That is 8, remainder 1. The one remaining will join 2 to give us 12. Now, how many 2 can we see in 12? That is 6. Now we continue to divide again using 2. 2 in 686. We start by saying 2 in 6, that's giving us 3. 2 in 8, that's giving us 4. And 2 in 6, that's giving us 3. So it means 2 in 686 is giving us 343. We continue. What can divide? The next number that can divide is 7. When we say number that can divide, we mean a number that can divide without leaving a remainder. I could think of using 3, but when I use 3 to divide 343, I will get a remainder. But in this case, we don't need a remainder. So we move to the number 7. How many 7 can we see in 343? We start by saying 7 in 34. That is giving us 4. Because 4 times 7 is 28. So that means there's a remainder of 6. So 6 will join 3 to give us 63. How many 7 can we see in 63? That is 9. Now we divide again. 7 can divide. How many 7 can we see in 49? That is 7. Now we have 7. 7 divided by 7 will give us 1. So this means that we've been able to break down 2,744 into 2 times 2 times 2 times 7 times 7 times 7. Now, it is from these numbers we are going to get the number that we can multiply by itself 3 times to give us 2,744. Now, we have 2,744 equals 2 times 2 times 2 times 7 times 7 times 7. So now we have the number 2 appearing 3 times, number 7 appearing 3 times. So this means if you try to combine them, 2 joins 7, that is 2 times 7. 2 joins 7, that is 2 times 7. 2 joins 7, that is 2 times 7. So this means we've been able to divide them into pairs. 2 times 7 is giving us 14. 2 times 7 is giving us 14. 2 times 7 is giving us 14. So this means that we have 14 times 14 times 14. That means we've gotten a number that when multiplied by itself 3 times, it will give us 2,744. So this means that the cube root of 2,744 is 14. So whenever you have a big number and you have to find the cube root, just try to break down these numbers into smaller forms. And guess what? When you break it down to smaller form, it will be easy for you to handle. Alright? So, the correct option is option A, 14. That is how you find the cube root of numbers. Also, try as much as possible to memorize the cube of smaller numbers. That is, when we say the cube of 2, it means 2 multiplied by itself 3 times is giving us 8. So it means when you have to find the cube root of 8, you are going to know that, oh, the answer is 2. So, do justice to knowing the cube of smaller numbers, at least between 1 to 20. Now, let's continue to the next question. Question number 7. Find the LCM of 165 and 210. We have the options. A, 21,203. B, 2,310. C, 2,013. D, 2,230. E, 2,103. Now, you know that LCM means the least common multiples. It means you have to find the least common multiples of 165 and 210. How do we solve for LCM? There are 3 different methods you can use to solve for LCM of numbers. 1, you can use prime factorization method, or you use listing of multiples method, or you simply use the division rule. That is, you keep dividing with prime numbers. Now, for this question, we are going to be using prime factorization method. Now, using prime factorization, this means that we have to break each number, that is 165 and 210, into products of their prime factors. That is, we are going to express them as a product of prime factors, such that when we multiply the prime numbers together, we are going to get the given numbers. Now, looking at 165. 165, when broken down into prime factors, we have 3 times 5 times 11. How can you get that? Start by dividing 165 by the smallest prime number that can divide 165. And looking at the smallest number is 3. So if you divide 165 by 3, you are going to get 55. Now, 55 is not a prime number. That means you could still break it down. And 55 is the same thing as saying 5 times 11. Now, 5 is a prime number. 11 is also a prime number. That is done for 165. So we move to 210. We also break 210 down. By breaking it down, we have 210. We divide by the smallest prime number, which is 2, because 210 is an even number. So if we divide 210 by 2, we are going to get 105. Now, 105 is not a prime number. It means we could further break it down. Now, if we divide 105 by the smallest possible prime number that can divide 105, we are going to get an answer. So 105 divided by 3, which is the next possible prime number that can divide, because 2 cannot go in 105. So we use 3, and that is giving us 35. Now, 35 is the same thing as saying 5 times 7. So this means that 210 is equal to 2 times 3 times 5 times 7. Now, how can we get the LCM? LCM is when we pick all these numbers without repeating any. That is, in a situation whereby we have 3 in 165 and 3 in 210, we are going to make them a single number. That is why we collect the common prime factors. So the common prime factors, we have 3 here, 3 here, and we also have 5 here, 5 here. So this means instead of writing 3 and 3, we are going to just pick one of these 3, and we pick one of these 5. So now the LCM is the product of all the prime numbers. 2 times we pick one of these 3, 3 times we pick one of these 5, 5 times 7 times 11. Now when we multiply, 2 times 3, that's giving us 6. 6 times 5, that's giving us 30. 30 times 7, that's giving us 210. 210 times 11, that is 2310. So, as you can see, we have gotten the LCM of 165 and 210 to be 2310. Remember, you can use any method and we are going to get the same answer. So, try using any other method and be sure you get 2310 to be the LCM. So the correct option is option B, 2310. Now we move to the next question. Question number 8, find the HCF of 168 and 189. We have the options A, 14, B, 15, C, 19, D, 16, E, 21. From the question, HCF means highest common factors. That is, we have to find the highest common factor of 168 and 189. Finding highest common factor, we can use either prime factorization method, listing of factors method, or we use the division method. Also, in this video, we are still going to solve using prime factorization. We have to find the HCF of 168 and 189. So using prime factorization method means we have to express 168 and 189 as a product of their prime factors. Now, 168, when we break it down into small prime numbers, we are going to get 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 7. If you multiply these together, we are going to get 168. How do we get these numbers? We get this number by breaking 168 into smaller form using prime numbers. That is, we have 168. We are going to divide it with the first smallest prime number, which is 2. So if we divide 168 by 2, we are going to get 84. Now, 84 can also be further broken down. When we divide 84 by 2, we are going to get 44. If we divide 84 by 2, we are going to get 42. Also, we can still divide 42 by 2 and we will get 21. Now, 21 is 3 times 7. The same applies to 189. We can break down 189 into small prime numbers. That is, when we divide 189 by the smallest prime number that can divide through, we are going to get a figure. 189 divided by 3 is giving us 63. We can still break down 63 by saying 63 divided by 3, we get 21. 21 is now the same thing as saying 3 times 7. That is how we break down bigger numbers into prime factor form. Now, the HCF is the common factors. So we check, what are the common factors? We have 2 in 168, but there's no 2 in 189. So it means 2 is not a common prime factor. Now we check, There's a 3 in 168 and there's 3 in 189. So 3 is a common factor. Also, there's 7 in 168 and there's 7 in 189. So it means 7 is also a common factor. So picking 1 from 3 here, picking 1 from 7 here, we have 3 times 7. And that's giving us 21. So this means the highest common factor of 168 and 189 is 21. Looking at the option, the correct answer is 21. I hope you are enjoying this video. Please, if you have questions, put it down in the comment section and your question will surely be answered. Now let's move to the next question. Question number 9. Simplify open bracket 1 whole number 2 over 3 minus 1 whole number 1 over 2 close bracket plus open bracket 3 whole number 1 over 2 minus 2 whole number 2 over 3 close bracket. We have the options. A, 1 whole number 1 over 6. B, 1. C, 1 over 3. D, 5 over 6. E, 1 over 5. This is a question of fractions. We need to perform the required operation to get our answer. Now we have 1 whole number 2 over 3 minus 1 whole number 1 over 2 in a bracket plus 3 whole number 1 over 2 minus 2 whole number 2 over 3 in another bracket. Now to make work very easy for us, we are going to start by simplifying each bracket. Now looking at the first bracket, we have 1 whole number 2 over 3 minus 1 whole number 1 over 2. Now simplifying this, this is a mixed fraction. 1 whole number 2 over 3 is the same thing as saying 1 plus 2 over 3 minus minus 1 whole number 1 over 2 is the same thing as saying 1 plus 1 over 2. Now because of this minus, we are going to put 1 plus 1 over 2 in a bracket so that the minus can affect the two numbers. Now we have 1 plus 2 over 3. Minus will multiply 1, that's minus 1. Minus will multiply plus, that is minus. Then we have 1 over 2. Now let's simplify this. 1 and 1, they can come together. That is 1 minus 1, that is giving us 0. So we have 2 over 3 minus 1 over 2. We leave it in this form. Now the next bracket, 3 whole number 1 over 2 minus 2 whole number 2 over 3. 3 whole number 1 over 2 is the same thing as saying 3 plus 1 over 2 minus 2 whole number 2 over 3, which is the same thing as saying 2 plus 2 over 3. We put 2 plus 2 over 3 in a bracket because of this minus. Now this is giving us 3 plus 1 over 2. Minus will multiply 2 to give us minus 2. Minus times plus, that is minus. Then we have 2 over 3. Now we have 3 and 2. 3 minus 2 will give us 1. Then we have plus 1 minus 2 over 3. We leave it in this form. So the next thing, 1 whole number 2 over 3 minus 1 whole number 1 over 2, which has already given us 2 over 3 minus 1 over 2. Then we have plus 3 whole number 1 over 2 minus 2 whole number 2 over 3. When we simplify this, we got 1 plus 1 over 2 minus 2 over 3. Now let's collect like terms. 2 over 3 here, 2 over 3 here, they will come together. Minus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2, they will come together. Then we have plus 1, so we have plus 1 here. 2 over 3 minus 2 over 3, that is giving us 0. Minus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2, that is also giving us 0. So we are left with 1, which is the right answer. So simplifying the expression, we got our answer to be 1. And the correct option is option B, 1. So when you have to solve questions like this, you try to convert your mixed fraction into a smaller expression. You can also convert it to improper fractions to solve and get your answer. And you can also say 1 whole number 2 over 3 is the same thing as saying 1 plus 2 over 3. Doing any of those you are going to end up with the same result. Now, let's solve the last question for this video. Question number 10. I owe a sum of 220 naira and was able to pay 110 naira. What percentage could I not pay? We have the options: 54%, 44%, 50%, 40%, 20%. Now, from the question, I owe a sum of 220 naira. So amount I owe is 220 naira and was able to pay 110 naira. That means the amount I paid is 110 naira. Now, what percentage could I not pay? It means you have to first of all find an amount that is left to be paid. If I borrow 220 naira and I'm able to pay 110 naira, it means amount left is the 220 naira that I borrowed minus 10 naira that I paid. So it means I'm still yet to pay 110 naira. Now we need to find the percentage that could not be paid. What is the percentage? Now, first of all, we look at the amount left. The amount left is 110 naira, which is half of the amount I owe. So because out of the money I borrowed, I was able to pay half and I'm owing half. It means after 100%, I'm able to pay for 50% and I'm still owing 50%, which is half of the total percentage. So this means the percentage left is 50%, which is the amount that I'm yet to pay. And the correct option is option. So I hope learning with us is fun and easy. Remember, if you have questions, please put it down in the comment section. Also, you can join us on WhatsApp, where you can get easy access to all tutors. When you need to ask questions, we are ready to answer you. Remember to still subscribe to our YouTube channel to get access to all our videos and many more opportunities that are yet to come. So thank you very much. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.